Chapter 2, Forgive and Forget. The Almighty, the Creator of the Universe, our Master, God is very kind. Every human being certainly makes mistake at some point. When we ask for His pardon and His forgiveness, the King God forgive us. To err is human. None of us is free from faults. When we are forgiven by our parents, friends and by the Almighty, we should too forgive those who do us wrongs. For forgiveness is one of the noblest values of mankind. It has been rightly said, forgiveness is the best of all forms of revenge. The quality of forgiveness makes us kind, merciful and compassionate. The real test is when we can forgive and forget the faults and mistakes of our enemies. So, let's read the story. Once there was a man named Yusuf. He lived in Arabia. One night, he was sitting in his tent. It was very cold and chilly night. The cold was unbearable. Suddenly, someone knocked at the door. "Who are you?" asked Yusuf. "Sir, I am a stranger." "I want shelter," replied the stranger from outside. "I shall be very thankful and obliged to you if you allow me to stay in your tent only for tonight." "I shall leave your tent tomorrow early in the morning," the stranger again said. Yusuf opened the door and asked the stranger to come in. The stranger was tired, hungry, and also was shivering with cold. Yusuf asked him, "Where are you coming from in this cold night?" "Sir," the stranger said, "I have offended the king on a small matter, so the king's soldiers are after me. I am moving here and there to save my life." Yusuf gave him food and a blanket and said, "Don't worry, young man, no harm shall come to you. You look very tired. Go for a sleep. I shall see you tomorrow. What can I do for you?" Early in the morning, Yusuf heard some movement of horses. He saw the king's men were moving in search of the stranger. Yusuf woke up the stranger and said, "Look, young man, it is still dark. It is the right time for you to escape. You may go from the other door of my tent." The stranger was moved by Yusuf's hospitality and generosity. He confessed that he was none other than murderer of his son and said, "You may hand me over to the soldiers. I am a sinner." Yusuf pardoned the stranger and said, "My son cannot come to life at any cost, but your life can be saved. So you run away and protect your life." The stranger's heart got changed. He took a vow not to harm anybody in future. The stranger rode away across the desert. Forgiveness is a great quality. All the great men had the quality of forgiveness. You might have heard the story of crucifixion of Lord Christ. When Jesus Christ was put onto the cross, he prayed to God, "O Lord, forgive them, for they know what they are doing." How great was Christ's forgiveness! Maharishi Dayanand forgave the person who had poisoned him. He was poisoned by his cook. When Dayanand came to know about this, he immediately called his cook, gave him some money and asked him to run away and to save his life. In this way, Maharishi Dayanand saved the life of the very person who had poisoned him. Dear children, if we don't forgive a person and continue to carry a grudge, we would be causing harm to our body, mind and soul. But if we forgive a person, we feel light at heart and get internal satisfaction. Many people think that forgiveness is a sign of weakness, but it is not true. As only a strong person can forgive, it is rightly said, forgiveness is the ornament of the brave and it is next to godliness. Mahatma Gandhi, the father of our nation, who led our freedom struggle, was embodiment of forgiveness. Though he was treated very badly by the British, yet he was never bitter or vengeful towards them. He fought against them through non-violence means. Remember, when we forgive someone, we act in a divine manner. Nobody is perfect and all of us can make mistakes. So they should pardon every enemy. Love and compassion can win over evil hearts. Forgiveness heals all wounds and settles all quarrels. Hate sin and not the sinner.